Hello everyone, this is Jan Chromý and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and its Use. In this presentation we will discuss word recognition as a key issue in the research of language comprehension. While discussing language comprehension in general, we may focus on two types of processes. On one hand, there are bottom-up processes. These are the processes which use the information from the lowest levels, from which they build up the higher structures. On the other hand, we also use the so-called top-down processes, which employ various sources of information to process the linguistic signal. This is a simplistic schema of the bottom-up processes in spoken word recognition. This is something we would probably expect. We hear someone speaking, we discriminate the individual phonemes, and based on that, we identify the words. Obviously, in reality, it is not that simple, and there are various models how this process actually works. Here we have a schema of the top-down processes. We may distinguish three main sources of information we might employ. First, we may use contextual information to understand what is being said. By context, we mean both the linguistic context, that is, what has been said before, or the situational context. Second, we may use linguistic knowledge in top-down processing. For example, we may know the verb's subcategorization frame, so we may expect how a sentence will continue. Third, our real-world knowledge helps a lot in word recognition. For example, based on our real-world knowledge, we know that certain things are plausible and other things implausible. These three sources of information can, of course, interact with each other. Top-down processing is something which is well known since early research in psycholinguistics. In 1970s, Richard Warren and Rosalind Warren published a study of the so-called phonemic restoration. Their research showed that context can play a crucial role in how do we recognize words. Warren and Warren ran an experiment which used very similar sentences which contained a word whose first phoneme was replaced with a cough. These sentences differed only in the word in the end. There were four sentences. It was found that the eel was on the ale. It was found that the eel was on the shoe. It was found that the eel was on the table. And it was found that the eel was on the orange. From the physical perspective, everybody heard the same sound. But according to the authors, the participants had the impression that they heard different words in each sentence. In the first sentence, they claimed that they heard the word wheel. In the second sentence, they stated that they heard the word heel. In the third one, they said that they heard the word meal. And in the fourth one, they claimed that they heard the word peel. This was obviously due to the sentence ending noun, which created a specific context for each sentence. Importantly, Warren and Warren claimed it was not only that the participants consciously replaced the cough with a specific phoneme or phonemes, but that they had the illusion that they really heard the phonemes. Altogether, this experiment nicely demonstrates that the top-down processing may be influenced by the linguistic context. Before we will conclude this presentation, I have one reading tip for you. If you want to learn more about spoken word recognition, you may be interested in the book Speech Perception and Spoken Word Recognition, which was edited by Gareth Gaskell and Jelena Mirkovic. If you enjoyed the presentations, we would be glad if you would like them on YouTube. That is all from me now. See you next time.